Professor in EC Department from St. Martin's Engineering College. Today I am going to explain about operational amplifier. What is mean by an operational amplifier? Basically, operational amplifier, it is an amplifier. Here it is an input signal. In early days, digital computers were not evolved. Mathematical operations were being performed using the operational amplifier. Those are the differentiation, addition, subtraction, differentiation, and integration. By taking few resistors and capacitors, it is possible to perform the mathematical operations. That is known as an operational amplifier. By connecting the few resistors and capacitors, it is possible to perform mathematical operations that are the addition, subtraction, differentiation, and integration. These are the operations performed using the operational amplifier. Let us see the schematic symbol of an operational amplifier. Operational amplifier having the two input terminals and one output terminal. One is inverting terminal and another one is non-inverting input terminal. Inverting input terminal and another one is non-inverting input terminal. Inverting input terminal is with negative sign, non-inverting input terminal with positive sign, and another terminal is output terminal. To this operational amplifier, there are two power supplies, DC power supply, we can say it as a plus VDC, and another one is minus VDC. This is the schematic symbol of operational amplifier. Let us see the construction of an operational amplifier. I am writing here itself, just look into this. Here, in this, input impedance, this is the construction of, what I am saying, operational amplifier is, just by connecting few resistors and capacitors, it is possible to perform the mathematical operations. Like that, this is the construction of an operational amplifier. In this, I am taking input impedance, and here it is a signal, input signal with the resistor giving to the output terminal. Here it is the output terminal. DC supply voltages, one is plus DC and another one is minus DC. Now, let us see ideal operational amplifier characteristics. Ideally, operational amplifier draws no current. Means, it will take, for operational amplifier, the difference between the two input voltages will be taken as an input to the operational amplifier. Let us suppose this is the V1. This is V1, negative, positive. V1 is inverting and non-inverting terminal is V2. See, the difference between these two voltages is taken as an input to the operational amplifier. Means what we can say, the differential voltage as an input to the operational amplifier. See, means the input here it is V in is equal to, we can write it as the difference between V1 minus V2. The difference means that these are the input difference between V1 and V2 as an input. We can write it as differential voltage VD. This is applied as an input to the operational amplifier. Ideally, it draws no current because the amplifier should be, if it is to be an ideal op amp, it should have following characteristics. What are those characteristics? Let us see. One is open loop gain, we can say. Open loop gain. Open loop gain means without any feedback to the operational amplifier, what is the gain we are obtaining at the output? That gain we can call it calling it as an open loop gain. If the operational amplifier should be and should be ideally means, it should follow the following characteristics. One is open loop gain is infinity. That we can say it as A open loop gain is equal to infinity. And second one, input impedance, that is input impedance is infinite. Same, R input impedance is infinite. And third one is output impedance. Output impedance is zero. If the operational amplifier is an ideal condition, follow the ideal conditions means open loop gain must be infinity and the input impedance must be infinity and the output impedance R naught is equals to zero. And fourth one, bandwidth. Bandwidth is also infinite. These are the four ideal op amp characteristics. Ideal here, op amp draws no current. This is draws no current. So the current to the input terminals I1, we can say it as a both inverting and not. We are having two input terminals, so I1 and I2. For these draws no current means for the inverting input terminal I1 is equal to 0 and also non-inverting terminal I2 is equal to 0. So both I1 and I2 values are equal to 0 here. Now see, for the operational amplifier we are giving the differential voltage as an input. So for this I am explaining inverting and non-inverting amplifiers. What are the two types of amplifiers we are having? One is inverting input terminal. So inverting amplifier, let us see the inverting amplifier. Inverting amplifier circuit with the feedback network. Let us suppose this is the operational amplifier having the input terminal with the resistors Rin. Input resistor Rin. Here, this is the inverting terminal I am saying. Inverting terminal is with minus. Means, why we are calling it as inverting terminal? The output voltage is out of phase with the input terminal. In that case, 180 degrees of output voltage is out of phase with the input voltage VI. So we are calling it as inverting input terminal. Here I am giving input to the inverting amplifier, right? Through the resistor RA, I am applying a feedback resistor here. Why we are giving a feedback resistor? What is the gain we are obtaining? Closed loop gain. Here the gain which we are obtaining is closed loop gain. What is the difference between open loop and closed loop gain? When we are giving a feedback path from output to the inverting or non-inverting terminal, the gain obtained we are calling it as a closed loop gain. This is the output voltage V0. this is I'm taking the inverting terminal, so I'm applying input to the inverting terminal. This is with inverting, and the another terminal, non-inverting terminal, here it is grounded. Okay, here it is V in we can see the current flowing. Let us suppose take this is a node X. Here the actually operational amplifier draws no current via sleep. There are two rules here. Operational amplifier draws no current, there are two rules to remember about this. V1 is always equal to V2. See, one is it is draws no current, and second one is V1 is always equal to V2. Here I am applying the Vn as an input. Here operational amplifier draws no current. So current here is Iin, it is flowing here. To the inverting input terminal, there is no current is flowing. So in V1 and V2 here are equal. So Iin is the input current flowing through the resistor Ra, and also to the feedback there is no input. Actually at the node X I am saying it as virtual ground. I'm taking the X node. Here it is virtual ground. I'm saying so the current which is flowing through the RA, the same current flows through the RF. So here we get input voltage Vin is equals to, we can write it as Iin RA, and also I can write this as Iin, where the current flowing is equals to Vin by Ra, right? Okay, this is, and one more thing, the output voltage V0, the current flowing through the feedback resistor is Iin only. So the voltage V0 is equals to, we can say it as minus Iin into RF. Okay, minus Iin into RF. What is the gain formula? Closed loop gain ACL is equals to what is the value? Output voltage to the input voltage. Right. Output voltage V0 to the input voltage Vin. What is the value for V0 here? Minus Iin RF by Vin is equals to Iin into RF. So here the value for closed loop gain V0 by Vin is equals to minus RF by Iin. Okay, here we can take that closed loop gain ACL is equals to minus RF by Iin. Here it is a negative sign which is indicating the inverting of output terminal with the input signal, means there is 180 degrees out of phase with the input signal, input voltage Vin. Okay, see, since always RF, this RF is feedback resistor, and this value Rin is must kept large, we should take the large value of input impedance value. We can say it as an infinite, okay? We can take up to infinite. Means if it is taking infinite input impedance, the loading effect can be avoided here. Because of why we are taking input impedance infinity, we are to avoid the loading effect. Or if you take to avoid the loading effect, I can take input impedance value must be large. Here the input impedance Ra and the output here it is RF. In place of Rin and RF, we can replace with impedances, means Zin as an input impedance and Zf is the feedback impedance. So we get the closed loop gain ACL is equals to minus Zf by Zin. We can write like this, right? This is the inverting operational amplifier. Let us see the non inverting